Me and Victoria met actually through her aunt. At one point, she called me because I worked at an office downtown. And she called me saying that she had Wi-Fi issues.
He did IT for the school, and she just, I guess, came up with a problem that the room was having, and he walked in.
And so she took me to the classroom that Victoria was in, and she was like, Wi-Fi issues. I have Wi-Fi issues. And she kept kind of nodding toward Victoria.
I had just gone to an eye doctor appointment, so I couldn't see. But all I could see was this short figure.
And so that's kind of where we first met. And then after that night, we exchanged phone numbers, and after that was all that.
It's his ability to always be lighthearted and just not take life so seriously. And he just kind of eases every situation, or he'll crack a joke or just do something silly just to ease the tension and to make me not feel as stressed.
She's very driven, but also she's just a very caring woman, and that's what I think also kind of drove me to her.
I don't think there was ever a moment where I didn't think that we wouldn't be together forever. There's a lot of moments along the way, and one funny one from when we had our first date. He was walking back to the car. We were leaving the movie theater, and he literally took my purse from me and just started walking me and opened the door, and I just thought it was so funny that a man would be okay to have my purse out in public and just to carry it.
Mom and Daddy are so proud of you, you beautiful bride.
Like the stars hold the moon. 3, 2, 1, no crying. No crying. No crying.
I love you.
I love you too.
Welcome, family and friends. Grant and Victoria have brought us all here today to celebrate their unity of love. I've known Victoria for 11 years now. We had many nights where we talked about her checkbox list. When she first met Grant, I will never forget the text and the phone calls that I received. And crazily enough, Grant had every box checked.
Grant, as I stand here before you, I see all of the things I fell in love with. You're the most caring and selfless person. You fill every day with silliness and laughter. I hope that our children inherit this from you. You love me through my grouchiness and inevitably tuck me in for my much-needed nap. You make loving you easy, and it's frustrating. I promise to talk through the good and the bad. I promise to always try your food first. I vow to always choose honesty. I vow to respect and encourage and support you. I promise to keep filling our dictionary with new words and names for Apollo Tootie Booty Brazzle. I cannot wait to see where this life takes us. Here are my person, and with you I'm home.
Victoria, I love you. For the past 3 years, you've become my best friend, my soulmate, Tootie Booty's mom, and more importantly, the love of my life. You make me feel happier than I have ever thought possible, and felt loved more than I can imagine. I love how you wear your heart on your sleeve, and the compassion that you show towards others. I remember the day of our relationship that flipped upside down, but for the better. You showed up one normal day for dinner, and hours later you got a text from work that you had been exposed to COVID. Oh. And we decided at that point, what better time to test our relationship than a 2-week quarantine. And so, well, those 2 weeks turned into a month. That month turned into a year. And that year turned into two more. Now we are committing our lives to each other, and thinking back, that quarantine has transitioned to a lifetime of happiness, and I couldn't be more grateful for it. I promise to always communicate and be honest with you. I promise to let you fill up your plate with grand ideas of landscaping and the home renovations, just to realize it's probably too much to do in one day. I promise to never go to bed mad at you, but I also promise to always wait for you in the driveway after you drive home late at night. But most importantly, I promise to stand with you against any challenge God has put in front of us. I vow to be your loving and faithful husband now and forever. I was the first one to say it in our relationship, but I'm blessed to say it for the last time as fiancés. Victoria, I love you.
Grant and Victoria, having witnessed your vows of marriage before God, before family, before friends, gathered here today, by the authority invested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss your bride.